Hello guys, welcome to Learning with Prep Class. I am your tutor, Adindu. In this video, I'll be solving questions 20 to 23, which has to do with section F of the Ubosigo Quantitative Paper B, test 4 questions. After this video, you'll have gained understanding on how to carefully select the correct answer when solving questions in quantitative. It's usually fun having you guys around, and I know this video would be a worthwhile session. Do not forget to like and subscribe on our YouTube channel. You can go the extra mile of leaving a comment so we can communicate for effective learning. Without further ado, let's zoom in. So this section F, and we'll need to get some certain information and build an understanding on it so it can guide us in solving questions 20 to 23. Now it says the large box represents class 4 students. So this is the box that represents class 4 students. So basically, we don't need to read this. We have this here. This is the box for students who passed in arithmetic. It's a rectangle. And this is the box for students who passed in geography. You can see it is thicker. Then the dotted lines, the students who passed in English. Now, we are going to see another picture of the box merging together and filled with numbers. Let's check it out. So now we are going to be using this diagram, the understanding we build from this diagram, to solve questions 20 to 23. Now, if you look at this box like this, follow my cursor, is for arithmetic. Like this is for arithmetic. You can see it. So this thicker one is for geography. This is for geography. This thick one is for geography. Then the large box, the entire box, this large one entirely is for the students. So this one is for all of the students. And this small one here in between is for English. So with this, we are going to be answering questions 20 to 23. Take for instance, we say, which represents students that took only arithmetic. Only arithmetic would be 1, because 1 is for only arithmetic. What of arithmetic and maybe other subjects? Arithmetic and other subjects would be 4, would be 5, would be 2. Because for 2 is arithmetic and geography, for 4 it is arithmetic and English, and for 5 it is arithmetic, English, and geography. So with this, we're going to be solving questions 20 to 23. Let's get them done. So for question 20, which shape or shapes represent those who passed only in arithmetic? So let's look at the shape only in arithmetic. You can see it only in arithmetic. This shape is for only in arithmetic. And only arithmetic will be equal to 1. So 1 will be our correct answer. Let's check it out. Question 20, option A, 1 is our correct answer. Let's look at the next question. Question 21, which shape or shapes represent those who passed in all 3 subjects? All 3 subjects. Let's check it out. So in all 3 subjects, we need to find a shape that is covered, a number that is covered by all of the 3 subjects. And if we look at 4, 4 is only for arithmetic and English. You can see it's arithmetic and English. 7 as well is for only English. Only English is 7. 8 is for English and geography. English and geography. Y5 is for both arithmetic, English, and geography. All 3 subjects. So our correct answer would be 5. All 3 subjects equal to 5. Let's check it out. Question 21, option C, 5 is our correct answer. Let's look at the next question. Question 22. Which shape or shapes represents those who passed in English and geography, but not in arithmetic? So we are also going to be looking at our diagram, analyzing them to find the answer. Let's check it out. So it has to do with English, geography, not arithmetic. So let's look for English. This is space for English. So 7 is for English alone. 7 is for English alone. 8 is for English and geography, but not arithmetic. 5 is for English, geography, and arithmetic. 4 is for arithmetic and English. But if you are looking for the one for English and geography, not arithmetic, it will be 8. Because this is where the arithmetic line stops. It doesn't cover 8, but the geography line of the geography shape covers 8, and the English shape covers 8. So 8 is our correct answer. English and geography minus arithmetic, 8 is our correct answer. Let's check it out. Question 22, option E, 8 is our correct answer. Let's look at the next question. Question 23, which shape or shapes represent those who passed in arithmetic and English, but not in geography? Let's see how to get it done. So we are looking for arithmetic and English alone, but not in geography. Arithmetic and English alone, but not in geography. And if you're looking for arithmetic and English, it will be 4. Because 4 has to do with arithmetic and English, not geography. 5 is for includes geography, so it can be 5. 8 includes geography, so it can be 8. 7 is for only English, excluding arithmetic, so it can be 7. But 4 has to do with arithmetic and English, not geography. So 4 will be our correct answer. Let's check it out. Question 23, option C, 4 is our correct answer. Alright, this is how far we can go in this video. I hope we had fun. By analyzing the shapes, we could resolve the questions and get our answers correct. I'm using this timeout to ask us to join our WhatsApp group using this link below, so we can get updates on more videos to come, and we can ask questions and also comment on the previous videos we've seen. It was fun having you guys around. Till I come your way again. Bye.